Welcome to Bronze League Heroes. What? What is this? Why is this guy here? This is not what I had. I mean, Beastie's Cutie Club, it should be Beast Cutie's logo, but somehow in replay it shows me this guy. Okay, I'm not familiar with the StarCraft professional scene. I'm not really sure who that is. Is a caster or a professional player? I don't know. Anyway, I'm gonna bring you another ladder game that I played. So today I played as Protoss, and I finally finished my placement. I already did placement this season, but I quit the league. I got placed in plat and I quit my league. Now came back to play again the placement, and I got placed in diamond afterwards. This is one of the game I played, I think. Yeah, this is the last game I played, I think. Yeah, probably. Anyway, this is low diamond level, diamond 3, so the MMR is, should be 3.7k to 3.8k-ish. This kind of range, so you have an idea, rough idea, the skill level of the players on the map, including me. So yeah, so everything standard, warding off against Zerg. I scouted with a probe as always. Always scout with a worker in case he does something cheesy, you know, pull first and stuff. So I scouted that his pull was indeed pretty late. I mean, he went expo first, so that means he won't have early links. It was pretty safe. I even took his, like, threw down a pylon to block his third, which is can be annoying, but in this game I don't think it really affected him. Let's see if he sees it. He doesn't see it right now, but he will see it very soon because he used Zergling to take it down very quickly. Anyway, getting natural expansion finally. All right, let's speed it up a little bit. So there's nothing special here. So everything's standard, I suppose.
Glory to the Daylong.
I gotta have that adapt to block the wall. Have to hold position. All right, he started to claw away my pylon, and I built that Twilight console to get in order to what's the upgrade for the depth? Anyway, I was going for some adept harassment. So.
Research complete.
Alright, at this point I have worker lead, which is nice, which is also good for the third player, I suppose. Got way too many lanes.
Glory to the Daylong.
I think he's overreacting. And yeah, he got too many lanes and he can't attack, so it's pretty much useless. And I'm about to get a third 10 lanes. Where did he put these lanes? Home, yeah, went home. All right, he's banking up a lot of resource, so I suppose he's like maybe high plat level actually. So diamond player shouldn't bank up this much at 5 minutes. That's crazy. Let's check out the worker counts. I have 36. Yes, 34. Okay, so usually at 5 minutes mark in the Zerg player, ideally should have 50 and above 50. Workers, and he has only 44, so that's kind of subpar. But that's only macro game. If you have some cheesy early game or intense early pressure, then yeah, okay, you don't have to have 50 drones at 5 minutes. But my opponent is kind of late on droning because of the lanes, 10 lanes built. So if he didn't build that lens, he could have much better, faster economy. So it maybe it all comes down to scouting. If he scouted the overlord, he will see that they find a threat early on or not. Let's see. He doesn't see his posse here. He has no vision at all inside my base. He has the overlord here, which is pretty much useless. He should put it at least here so he knows what if I'm mining, if I'm saturated on a natural. So he pretty much has no idea what I was going for. He has no idea if I have a multiple gates or which tech I'm going for. So really, as third player, you want to ideally get the overlord speed so you can run the overlord all the way across your opponent's base, and you know, just sacrifice it. Sometimes a sacrifice of overlord is good, especially because in PvZ it's not always that the Protoss player will get a stalker, so sometimes you can just walk away for free. You just scout and fly away like a balloon. How wonderful. Why don't you do that? So Zerg players, remember to scout your overlord, fly across your opponent's base. Right. So I got some Adept Rats here. How many games did I kill? Five only. Well, I killed five, but I guess it is good enough damage. Alright, he got really a lot of lings. 46 lings running across the map. It's really intimidating. Let's see what he can do. Alright, economy wise, we're pretty much equal. But then he had this attack which wrecked my third base. Let's see. That's a lot of things. Wow. Demolish my units. And third. Rest in peace. I have pretty much no units against this. Yeah, there's some adepts. For the third, immediately cancelled. And of course, these lings, the number of lings is not enough for my adepts right now. Alright, so we have stabilized and we're back to good old macro. I still use, all unit hard hotkeys on my observer back. Rebuild my third. At this point, I'm behind economy-wise. Let's see. He has one, two, three bases, and he's building his fourth, and I'm only two bases. So that's a problem for me, right? Really, that's a problem. Really, if you play like this, you're dead. But I guess my opponent didn't really utilize the advantage. Because I won, right? I know the result. I won the game. So I send some more adepts across the map to do some damage, because I know I'm behind and I have to, you know, keep him on his toes and cannot let him just rest at peace. I must make him nervous and always, you know, worried about this and that, and build more units so he's not drawn up as much. It's good damage. Or not. Probably not. Got red so fast. Alright, killed 13 joins in total. Not ideal. But he already had so many units, so yeah. Okay. So he at 9 minutes mark. He has okay, 70 joins, so that's fine. I was about to say 60 is not enough. Yeah, he needed at least 70 joins. Okay, I was just getting some archons, because they encounter links. That's what I was thinking. Also, I saw the Hydras. Archon also does pretty well against the Hydras, so yeah. So at this point, I'm catching up. You can see he's still banking up. So yeah, if he could just spend all this money, he would have won me twice over. Okay. Great, I have plus one, he has nothing, and what are we building? I'm getting plus one armor, he's getting plus one range upgrade. What else is... Okay, I'm doing some fast expression here. I'm getting back on my feet, I'm recovering economy, I'm even surpassing him. Get a second force to get upgrade, give me an extra edge on the battlefield. No more gates to secure the fourth base. I got some cannons and that shield battery. And let's see what my opponent is going for. He is building lurker den. Yeah, he was going for lurkers and he did mass lurker build. Unfortunately, oh wow, that's a lot of lurkers. Okay, that's how many? 15. Unfortunately, I had observers. So. All right, I had I was going for storms, and this game is mass storm versus lurkers, mass lurkers. Let's see how it plays out. How many high templar do I have? Let's count. I have this is 8 plus 3 is 11. Okay, I send some more adepts across the map just to do some damage. Okay, he's moving across. Is he moving across or he's just A moving? F2 move. Probably F2 A move. But good thing is he left his lurkers here, so I can't attack directly. Yeah, but I didn't have that plan. I wasn't going fancy. I was just doing normal. Good old macro build a death bomb and roll over him. That was my plan. Okay, nothing fancy here. I had upgrade lead because I have chrono boost, so that was good. And also I have a unit. I have a supply lead. I'm almost maxed, and he has still 26. Supply to fill up. Okay, he decided to move out, and I decided to move out at the same time. I saw it up, obviously, and he can hit me. I can hit him, so I throw some storm and fall back. Yeah, and I put down some more storms. His lurkers are really concentrated in the era, so it's really good. Good for me because I can just keep throwing storms. And still, I think these lurkers do a lot of damage to me. Especially I have so many high timers, including Vanguard here. Wow, those storms really rip through those. Oh my gosh, where's my detection? Where's my detection? Out of detection. I have one observer. Where is it? Here. Here comes our observer. I lost observer there. Unfortunate. Alright, he's on 5 bases. I'm on 5 bases. Oh no, I'm sorry. I'm on 4 bases. Alright, so I'm moving out. I don't care. I know I can beat him because I have mass storms. Do I have better upgrade? Yeah, we have evil upgrades. It's fine. Also, at this point, as long as I keep building units and keep reinforcing my units, it's a GG for me. So yeah, these storms definitely rip through all these minions. You should definitely not build minions. You should try to build some roaches and hedges. But it's too late. Even though he has so much resources, he doesn't have the time to build those units. Alright, storm is beautiful. Get 33 workers. Alright, so that's a GG. Oh! His last resort is archers. Does he have the extra armor upgrade? Let's check. 6 armor. I'm not even sure. I never go for. He probably has the extra armor upgrade. good for him, but it's just I have way too many units. So it's impossible to come back unless you are Terran playing Bile, then yeah, I'll just rule over you. Alright, that's GG. So any lesson you can learn from the game is I put some more scouting so that my third won't be denied if I see the links coming over. And also, you know, I send the depths. I should have built more depths faster so that I could defend it in time. I was a little bit late on that. Besides those, everything was fine. So my third was really delayed, which gave me a huge handicap. I came back from real behind and managed to come back, which was nice. And I could have gone for more expansions, but I didn't spare those APMs. We'll try next time. And I got a double upgrade and chrono boosting them, which is nice. I got plus 3 in the end. So that's good. Keep it up. Alright, this is the game. Thank you for watching. Hope you are entertained. Otherwise, I have to put my foot on the keyboard to play. Alright, see you.